First, I would like to say, to express my greetings, warm greetings, not cold greetings, warm greetings, and really. And really, blin zillion trillion numberless things. This time, this life. that we are not cross our mind, not falling towards the, you know, closed mind, open mind, free yourself. With an open mind, free yourself. Like you see in the pot, flies get caught in the pot, but there's a hole, but there's a whole space to come out, but I can't see. Oh, it goes round inside the pot. Means to try to get the outside, but can't. It's just there, very close there, just to come out, big space. You know, the pot is very small. But go round, but try to get outside. The expectation is that. But couldn't see the, just there, hole, big hole just there. Can't see. For a long time, can't see. Just there. Can't see. Due to ignorance. Due to ignorance. If there's no ignorance, yes, you can see, just there. And also without ignorance, there won't be a block. So, but goes around, can't see, just there, can't see, just like that. Can't see, they go round, make a noise, you know, make a noise and go round. We hope to get out, but could never get out. So this time, we, meet each other, able to meet each other. I'm nothing special, but we had some connection in the past, some karma in the past. So that's why we met again together. There's a reason why we meet today. There's a reason. That came from Course. We created the Course in the past. Many times. So there's a reason. It's a causative phenomena. Our meeting each other today is a causative phenomena. It's not something happened without any reason, all of that. There's no way. Impossible. Impossible. Then it becomes independent. Truly existent. Independent. it becomes unreasonable, no reason. It exists upon its own side. Or the ghost in that way. And then that means whatever you do this morning, from this morning till night, everything. Everything dependent. Everything you see happened by itself, without any cause, conditions. So, person who's happy, who's unhappy, whatever happens, it just happened. It happened without any cause, conditions. So that means if you are sick, it cannot be treated because it exists from its own side. So no medicine cannot cure. Even that is another example. Medicine cannot cure because it exists from its side. It doesn't depend on cause conditions. It's not dependent rising. So nothing can help. Whatever happens, nothing can help. Sickness or whatever bad thing happened cannot help. So same thing from birth to death, whatever happens. So everything, nothing, you know, without everything, it happened by from its own side by itself. Without cause conditions, then from beginningless rebirth, the endless suffering, samsara, endless rebirth. Then there wouldn't be happiness and suffering also, because happy then become suffer, then you're happy then you suffer, you know, the changes doesn't happen, because changes happen by depending on cause conditions. So because depending on cause conditions, that's why medicine can help. That's why that by talking psychology, by talking help, by doing meditation can help, can bring happiness in the life, can bring happiness in the mind, inner peace. So this without talking about enlightenment or ultimate happiness, liberation from samsara, without talking any higher meditations, just temporary, it brings inner happiness through meditation. Without even high realization. There's sicknesses, and there's a cause of sicknesses. And so by eliminating the cause of sicknesses, then sickness can be stopped. That can be stopped to happen again. Well, similar, there's suffering because there's a cause of suffering. There's a cause of suffering. Mm-hmm. And the cause of suffering, even that is not just outside. Outside, there can be something, but that's condition. Even there's something, that's a condition. That's the main cause. That is a difficult one to discover. People in the world, most people in the world, think the outside condition is the main cause. Even outside condition is correct, but due to that, suffering happens, but that's just condition. What the major people in the world regard is just condition. There is a cause. There's a cause, main cause. That's the inner cause. That's the mind. Mind creates suffering, produces suffering. Produce suffering. Mind is the incorrect way of thinking. Total mistake of mind. Not knowing the ultimate reality of the phenomena. Not knowing that. Ultimate reality of the phenomena. The very nature of the phenomena. Not knowing that. What makes the trees exist? The dependent arising as gross and subtle. The subtle dependent arising. First of all, you have to know the gross dependent arising, then subtle dependent arising. So, not knowing that, what is subtle dependent arising, and that meaning of that into ultimate reality, emptiness only, Dongba Ni, only emptiness. In Tibetan, there's a word empty, only Dongba, emptiness, and Ni is only. Sanskrit Shunyata. So, subtle dependent arising, meaning of emptiness. Very nature, ultimate reality, not knowing that. So they are not knowing that. What exists, not knowing that. That is the inner meaning of subtle dependent arising, not seeing that. What exists? What doesn't exist? Totally what doesn't exist. Hallucination. The way things appear to our hallucinated mind. Total belief. We totally grasp or to totally entire. In touch that really exists. The hallucination, that which is a hallucination, really exists. 100% it exists. That is the basis of our problem in the life, what brings unhappiness, what blocks to achieve ultimate happiness. What brought us to achieve ultimate happiness, not temporal happiness, ultimate happiness, everlasting happiness. What brought this living, I'm not talking about enlightenment, ultimate happiness, everlasting happiness, no suffering, only happiness, no suffering at all, only happiness. All that. What brought to each of that is that. So that, and especially not knowing what is I. That's the very root. Oh, similar, you see, the eye. So, same mistake with the eye. That's the biggest mistake. I, what exists. In the man, so empty of existing from its own side, empty of the real. The I that is existing unification of subtle dependent arising. And emptiness, done by me. So we see that what exists, but can't see. That's like, the harder than rock a mountain or iron mountain. So hard to see that. It's like it doesn't exist. Nowhere. And I, what doesn't exist. Never exist, never happened. A second from beginningless rebirth. Real I, existing from its own side. Existing as a promise of that by itself. Or truly existing. Never happened even a second from beginning to birth. Even atom of that, real I, even atom of that, never exists. Or that we appear, it appears to us. It appears to us real. And we completely, without our interest, to cling, grasp our totally interested in that. We live with that. So what? Oh, that's the root of global problem. Where the global problem came from? That's the root. And where the country problem came from? The root. Where the society problem came from? Root. Where the family problem? Where the individual problem came from? That. Including diarrhea. Including headache, toothache, cancer, AIDS, anything. Including suffering from death, suffering from old age. The Michael was, is the American. The American, the... I think Raja just woke up. When he heard Michael, he said, okay. 이 놀라상이지. 이제 따라 하우스 오스트리아 멜번 계신 동안 스탕슬리로 담망가 네네
아?
놀라상이지 예 마이클 잭슨
마이클 잭슨
so how many times he make? How many times he made a face? Going to face shop. How many times changed face? Yeah. Not only him, many people do that. Yeah, so, looking older, then you stretch out your skin, you fill it up. Oh, I don't know, but. Yeah, especially, I don't know, Europe or America. Yeah. Many people do that. So, that's not natural. Then they become old again. So again, change. Fill up the wrinkles. Then, yeah, so. Yeah, so old age, sickness, death, the suffering pain, the first type of, suffering or samsara, the first type of suffering or samsara, suffering pain. So all those problems which came from the very root, that called ignorance, that concept. That concept, that concept, but it's so subtle, it's not gross, not easy to recognize. So subtle, the real one. The second suffering, some suffering apply to second suffering. Some suffering pleasure. All this, pleasure, food, dress, house, and. Pledge for that, and then music, pleasure of sex, and pleasure of pleasure of climbing Mount Everest. So many people died this year. Best came to America, climb a mountain. So many people died. Oh. So they climb a mountain every day. Pleasure of climbing a mountain every day. But if it is for sentient beings to benefit the world, to benefit for the sentient beings, see what benefit. Even you are climbing the mountains, but what benefit it brings to a sentient being? If you analyze, there's nothing. I don't know anybody climbing the mountains. Think with your precious thought benefit sentient beings, I doubt. But even in case, what benefit is? So anyway, so there I'm using example. So anyway, like that, so many. So due that pleasure cannot continue, and it decreases, all the decreases, and then becomes suffering pain, and then it does not increase, doesn't go higher, hour by hour, day by day, you know, day by day, higher and higher. That's all. next day is incredible happiness, bliss. Next day is incredible happiness. Then the second day, third day, unbelievable, extraordinary happiness. Is it true to be like that? Not. But that's not happening. Why? That's a big question. Why is it not happening? Why doesn't it continue? Why not increase? Why? That's a good check. Those are science to check, not blind faith. Science. Inner science. So we see meditation, Dharma practice. Oh, your mind becoming Dharma, positive, healthy mind. Positive virtue, all means same. Oh, then goes from that your action, body, spirit, mind all become healthy. Healthy is, and I use the word healthy so much because it fits in the West. You know, the term fits in the West. So, healthy, virtue, positive, cause of happiness, not cause of suffering, cause of happiness. So, that. Then, from the healthy mind, the healthy body comes. Your mind can cure your disease. That's the best way. Otherwise, you take one medicine. It harms to some, it brings some other disease. It takes a long time. Then it happens something else. You see? So, safe is your mind cure your disease. Your positive mind, your healthy mind, your virtue thought cure your disease. Your mental disease, your physical disease. Even just thinking disease, you know, besides other things, other sufferings, physical, mental sufferings. So anyway, of course, pure. The even more pure mind, your mind even more pure. No suffering mind, attachment, painful mind, attachment to your future life samsara, even your future life samsara life. No suffering mind. No suffering mind attachment. No pain. No painful mind attachment. Healthy virtue. Even more pure. Then you see, able to achieve the are the everlasting happiness. No, oh, the suffering is that, and then, because realizing, seeing ultimate nature of the I. Ultimate nature of the I. What is the I? So there's existing in the say, existing in the my name. Meaning do not exist from its own side. Meaning it is empty of it is empty of what it has been appearing to us from beginningless rebirth. I, what has been appearing to the harvest mind, you know, existing from its own side, existing by itself, true existence, or real. The language we every day we talk, real. Oh, from beginningless rebirth, up to the second. Oh, that hallucination. Fourth eye. That do that. So fourth eye and we have been entrusting that from beginning lesser burden up to now. Up to this second. So totally hallucinated in the recognition of the I. In the recognition of you. We draw state. Who is you? Who are you? I mean, total hallucination. Wrong concept. Recognition of you. Biggest mistake. So as I mentioned, the suffering of pain, all that suffering of birth, all that sickness and death, everything. You know, you see, Nepal, just 2 weeks, you know. When I was there, I came from Mapla Mountain, which close to Mount Everest and Lhasa. Then from there, I came down to Kathmandu. After 2 days, then earthquake happened. Two big earthquakes. Then many small ones. Then I left three days ago, one big earthquake happened. And a little small one happened every day. So anyway, including earthquake, came to mind. Came from the ignorance, not the I. The big ignorance, the big wrong concept, is like the king of the delusions. So this ignorance came from that. Even this huge earthquake that nearly, I think, news, I think maybe it's 7,000 people or something. But however, But all over the world, Nepal, I think, probably if you count, probably 10,000 nearly, from villages very far. And, so it's so many dead. Ah, okay, all that, and then, then not dead, so many houses collapsed, and then, this is like 10,000 or something around, I'm not sure. Unbelievable. So, although also came from the mind, this wrong concept, this ignorance, ignorance holding the eyes real. What we're interested in now, right now. Real eye is listening, teaching. What we believe, the real eye is listening, teaching. The real me is giving teaching. Came from that. Even the earthquake. So whatever happens in the world came from any suffering, any undeserved thing came from the wrong concept. Any good thing came from the right concept. So, so I mentioned the second day I was outside. We were outside, Western sanghas and the students who came with the hike away, most secret hike away initiation at Kapan. So they asked me to give this initiation, and so I came down and thought they announced, and the older students came from Singapore and from different places. So but then when they came there, during their stay, they had to experience many earthquakes. That's the gift in Nepal. Present for them. So. And then, because I was telling them that outside, I was sitting there, I was outside, we were outside. The trees on the hill, like drunk, like this. Mm-hmm. The trees, even like that, you know. So we were, I don't know what prayer. We were doing prayer to control the earthquake. We'll do that, and some of the prayers we were doing. We tried to do prayer for all the people who died, the monks, students and monks outside. So in the, but nobody dead. A couple of nuns, monks, nobody dead. The old Gombas got some cracks and some, and they didn't see with eyes. But new ones, the Kapan, new Gomba, got some good completely stayed strong, even shaken, but not. The window has got a small crack, but the wound there, who did put her, he said, small cracks, but he wasn't sure there was something exist before. Or the nuns, Nyugomba, were just trying to finish, and inside, you see, no other damage, but boy, there were 17 pandits in those England, and those were, you know, holy great pandits in the ancient time. There were those who happened in India, so they so drew in the Gomba. So one I couldn't see from the my throne. I got a clear eyesight, so one, they said, one didn't get a crack, one got a crack, one, the painting of the pandit, the great holy being. One got a crack, and then, the painting, I didn't the actual pandit, but the painting, so one didn't get a crack. But another one got a crack, one didn't get a crack, but another one got a crack. It's very interesting, very interesting. Yeah. So I think, all that. So then I don't know what happened, the earthquakes later, you know. But there's another monastery just outside Kapan. There's one monastery, Nyima. Then straight from that, another hill has another monastery. I am Tugu, the one who teach power all over the world. Teach always power, transparent consciousness. Transparent consciousness in the pure land. So his monastery is finished some time ago, maybe about a year or some. But I heard the pillars got bent inside the Gomba, the pillars bent. The manager told the abbot of Kapan Monastery, Geshe Shunyi. So that was kind of very dangerous. That means we have to, you know, make new pillar, or I mean, that means a lot of fixing. So I was telling the sanghas and other students. You see, I was saying them came from self. This earthquake came from self-changing thought. Our self-changing thought. In the past, we created karma, negative karma, with the self-changing thought. So the killing, stealing, so forth. It is a result of ten and virtues and. So killing, stealing, a result of those nigdhama, however degenerated samaya. No question of that. Degeneration of samaya vow. So in the past, with self-taking thought, or looking, trying to achieve happiness for this I, you know, careless others, numberless, but only this, in the numberless Buddha, Bodhisattva, you know, then numberless other sentient beings, all the, you know, careless, but this, only this I, among all that, numberless hell beings, hungry gods, animal, numberless human beings, Sura beings, Asura beings, and then we say, but among all this, only this I, working for only this I, happiness only this I. So only cherishing this I, careless all this, looking only for happiness, dreams of happiness for this I. But reality, that real I, not that. In reality, that real I, if you look, is not there. Can't find. From the top, tip of the hairs down the toes, no way you can find. Mind is not I, body is not I, even together is not I. Living together is not I. And there's no real I exists separately from the aggregates. There's merely a I, but there's no real I exist separately from the aggregates without depending on aggregates. So it exists nowhere in this room, exists nowhere, even in this room, in your room, back to the house, even in this room, in the world, east, west, nowhere it exists. That's the reality. So then you see, I was telling them that, you know, when you do slaying the ego, we blow the Taibon, a human Taibon, we blow to bring the spirits, to invoke the spirits. And then first you do the wide distribution, your body transforms nectar, oceans of nectar, DMA offering to Guru Bhadama Sangha, the major field. And then you make a charity to six realm sentient beings, spirits and all that. That's one thing. The second, red dispersion, mountains of your bone, flesh, blood, skin, charity, you make charity to the spirits. So whatever they like to eat bone, they like to drink blood, whatever it is, flesh, horrible mountains, you make charity. So this is like you are being in the world, you are being in the war, in the war. You should be outside to attacking the enemy and the other side enemy. Other side army is enemy. So you are being outside. And whatever bombing, shooting, whatever you do, exposed, red mind, you know, like that. So you may change, you give up yourself to the spirits, sentient, mother sentient, suffering sentient being, mother spirits. You know? So you give. Charity like that, and then after that, they satisfy, then you make Dharma charity. So very encouraged kind of charity, you know, very brave charity. Oh, so like that. The bodhicitta, cherishing others. You know, cherishing others, and then the powerful, you crack the mountain, the stones, you put something dynamic. Do you put dynamic? Dynamic? Yeah. So like dynamic, you see. So this destroy the self-cherishing thought and cherish the spirit of the sentient beings. Cherish the most and then you destroy yourself, self-cherishing thought. So like that. Then making changes with him, something like that. And then the other one is I don't remember exactly what I said, but so the other one is that so they embody the spirits and they create violence to you. They create violence to you. So they create violence to you. It become very beneficial to you. The practitioner, meditator practitioner, jet is like the ego, it becomes so beneficial. So they create violence, all kinds of fearful violence they create. So then, that time, then you see emotional eye, the gakcha, object to be reputed. Tibetan language, gakcha, object to be reputed. Eye, the object to be reputed. Fourth eye. Fourth eye, which you don't know, easy to recognize. That time it blows up, emotion eye. So, when they create so much violence, it blows up your emotion eye. So then suddenly you come to know what the gakcha is. The fourth eye, that which you've been believing for beginningless birth, trust, in trust, this is totally true. That time then blows up. Emotional eye. You recognize. This is the false eye. What? By believing the truth, they have cheated you from beginningless birth. Not all this morning, not from birth, from beginningless birth, cheated you. Totally. Cheated you totally. That's why it's still suffering samsara. Still not free from suffering or rebirth, old age, sickness and death. Still not free. Still not free, still suffering. So like that. I didn't finish. Then still we're not free from the second suffering. Suffering a change, or the temporary samsara pleasure. That which cannot continue, which doesn't increase. That is because it is suffering nature. That is in suffering nature. So that could not continue, cannot increase. Where Dharma happiness, perfection, Dharma continuously, the Dharma happiness continues. Dharma happiness can be increased. And not only when you're free from oceans of samsara suffering, but when you achieve the total elimination or obscuration, completion of all the realization, when the power of the mind, when the potential of the mind completed that time. So, present Dharma, happiness completed. Kundin can increase, can complete. So, like that, the big difference. Samsara pleasure and Dharma happens. So, anyway, suffering which change, second suffering, or the temporary suffering pleasure, which is nature of suffering change. So that's because so still we are not we're not free from the first one, we're not free from the second one. And then third, we're not free from because we're not free from the third suffering, from where the true suffering comes, progressive compounding suffering. So the aggregates being under the control of karma and delusion, that's why nature of suffering. Instead of bliss, nature of suffering. Instead of bliss, free happiness. Instead of that, bliss is the only nature of suffering. So all of that, you see a press here, suffering. So the skin says, press, suffering. So there, I say, you know, in press, suffering, why? Well, that describes, you know, reincarnation, karma. Reincarnation, past life, future life. That explains so why they're suffering. Why they're suffering? What is the nature of suffering? Is bliss. Why not in bliss? That's a question. This is a big question. Why not in great bliss? Why not? So that's something that we should study, examine. And then the contaminated seed of disturbing thoughts. So that's why nature of suffering and compound suffering, this life, future life, this I guess. So we're not free from even third suffering. Because we're not free from third suffering, then that's why we experience suffering pain and suffering change. All of that. So from where we need to free from, the third suffering. Suffering change, and that previous compound suffering. We need to be free from that. Then you are free from suffering pain and suffering change. So then you have a total everlasting happiness. Ultimate happiness forever. There's one time you achieve, that's it. There's no again falling back into suffering. Then again you have to practice, again you have to maintain. No, that's impossible. There's no cause to come back. There's no, or the siege, or the siege of delusions completely ceased. Delusion, karma ceased. So there's no suffering. All of that. Can you go there? So So anyway, I'm thanking you from bottom of my heart this time, thinking, open your heart, giving freedom to yourself. Much of the human life, we don't give freedom to yourself. We don't give freedom to ourselves. It's like the flies staying inside. Even there's a hole just there, but can't see. So goes around, suffer, try to get out. So this time, give. Freedom to yourself. Freedom to yourself. So open your mind. Freedom to yourself. So that. And then also, many of you who are engaging in practice, literally learn or reflect meditation practice. So, many of you who are doing that. So I want really, it's unbelievable, most beneficial life, worthwhile. So to you and to all the sentient beings, that's best your help to numberless helpings, numberless hungry ghosts, numberless animals, numberless insects, mosquitoes, and numberless fish, different types of fish in the ocean, numberless in the ground, numberless animals in the ground, worms and so forth, on the ground, on the grass, so tiny flies live in the grass. When you walk, so many tiny ones jump away. So that, then in the space, such the animals are, just the animal, oh, unbelievable, all like that. Then the human beings, as scientifically mentioned, numberless universe, as well as Buddhas mentioned, all numberless human beings, swirling. So that's most beneficial. Learning meditation, learning Dharma, learning meditation, practicing, learning. In order to practice, you have to learn. So, learning, reflecting, meditation, all that. So, really, most beneficial for sentient beings. For all those sentient beings, most beneficial and lasting is you, even for yourself. So I want to thank really that's unbelievable, extremely worthwhile. So I was sorry. I was telling the monks and our Western students, and you know, the Chinese and so I was saying that you know, the earthquake is similar to the Jiu practice, invoking spirits to create violence, so that you can see the gapcha, objective repeat of false eye. So then, once you recognize, it's just a minute to realize shunyata, emptiness only. So that's that happened. Not many practices like that. So that's a good way to realize emptiness through practice che. So so I was saying that then to take it as take it in the way, that way, rather using only for fear. So that use it, take it, use it for practice to actualize the emptiness, or things like that. So of course you can use bodhicitta for sentient beings, to explain for sentient beings. But bodhicitta, you can do that. Then one sort of introduction. Then maybe you sort of perform your meditation. As I've been talking, so that means the hell, heavy suffering is called that. So hell suffering, heavy suffering, hell suffering. So six realms, sentient beings, heavy suffering, all the hell suffering. So that came from. That came from mind. That came from mind. This is a mind which experiences hell. It came from that mind. Came from our mind. It experiences that. Peerless happiness, peerless happiness, total elimination of obscuration, completion of realization, that sangye also came from the mind. What we're going to achieve? What we're going to achieve? That comes from our mind. The other one, hell, I already told. So enlightenment and full enlightenment. Peerless happiness. What we're going to achieve? No, comes from our mind. So the nirvana, the everlasting happiness, ultimate happiness, blissful state of peace for oneself. So now that which we're going to achieve, that comes from our mind, not come from inside, comes from our mind. And samsara comes from our mind. The opposite of that, samsara, second one, comes from our mind. Come from our mind. Came from our mind. And every day, problem, happiness come from our mind. You think a different way, you can solve the problem. You think a different way, you can able to solve the problem from the mind, from your mind. And you experience happiness. A correct way of thinking, healthy way of thinking, positive way of thinking, virtuous way of thinking. You bring happiness. Able to solve the problem. So when you change your mind from that, incredible thinking, all the unhealthy way thinking, then you are creating problem in the life. Problem to you, problem to others. So everyday life, problem, happiness, everyday life, come to your mind. For example, I'll tell my experience. For example, you know, sometimes somebody says some nasty things to you. You tell to do something the person didn't do. Person didn't do what you said. Or person didn't understand what you said, or something, you know, whatever. You see, then you have choice. You have choice whether to get angry or not. Do you understand what I'm saying? Sometimes you have choice. Should I get angry or not? Should I get angry to this person or not? You have choice. You can see you have choice. you have choice. Whether to get angry or not. Let me get angry. Then you get angry, you know, you show your face and you change your face and words and then, you know, that. But then before that, maybe not get angry, better than not get angry. Then it's okay, you know, sometimes you have choice, yeah? Or sometimes anger just like a volcano, like a gas. Sometimes you have choice. So I'm saying that didn't come from outside. I'm saying that even everyday life problem happens, it comes from your mind. Your way of thinking, how you take care of your mind, how you take care of your life. Every day depends how you take care of your life. Whether you take care of your life or not. If you are not taking care of your life, you get angry and do everything bad to harm you, harm others. But if you are taking care of your life, practice compassion and patience to others. You practice compassion to others, you practice patience to others. All right. Then from there you achieve. The Sangye, total elimination of obscuration, completion of realization. From there you achieve ultimate. So meantime, only in samsara, you don't go to the lower realm. Oh, it's unbelievable. happiness, life's life. Life's life, unbelievable happiness, good birth, so much success. Unbelievable success. So that, volume sometimes. So, all like that. So totally came from your mind, whole thing. Friend, enemy, strange, everything came from mind. Appearing the friend, enemy, stranger, all those things were appearing. All come from your mind. All to do with your mind. Your mind is the creator. The creator. So now, you see, example, further more example. You go back to childhood time, and so you go back to childhood time. So either your parents or your school teacher teaching you alphabet. Okay. So either your parents or school teacher wrote on blackboard like this, like that, like this, like that. Let's see, line like this, like this. So, you see, but you're not taught that by the teacher or parents. So for you, what appears, this line like this, you're not taught yet that, that is that. So, what appears to you is like just line like this. You don't have appearance that is that. You may have appearance of that, but you may not have appearance that is that. That is that. you wouldn't have appearance that before you are taught this is that. So the appearance for the appearance, this line on the blackboard. So that time you don't have appearance that this is that. Because your mind, so your mind hasn't labeled that. Your mind hasn't labeled that because that you have no appearance that is that. You have no appearance that is that. That time. And you don't see that is that at that time. No. You don't see that is that time. So down, last thing, you're seeing that is that. Don't have. Because you don't have appearance that is that. Because your mind hasn't leveled that yet. You understand? So, because your parents or your teacher hasn't taught you yet, this is that. You have no idea. So, when your parents or teacher taught you the label, or goes on top that, then you believe in that. You believe in that. You believe in that. You believe in that. You believe in that, you follow that, you believe in that. Then there's a, then you see, you say your mind label, that, you know, believe in that. Then there's appearance as projection, then there's appearance that is that. Oh, then you see that is that. So you see now here very clear, come from your mind. That just from that, example, you can see completely come from your mind. Very clear. That appears that to you. Appearing that to you. Come from your mind. Come from your mind. So like that, the same with the I come from the mind. The I come from the mind. I aggregate all like that come from the mind. I action object all from this moment today. I action object all the time. From this morning up to the night, you know, seriously. So from birth and death, I action object. From beginningless to birth, because Dharma achieving enlightenment up to there. I accept all came from mind. Came from your mind. So like that. Came from your mind. So see. So, so you see another question is there. You know, mind not produce suffering. We have to change the mind. Not produce suffering, produce only happiness. So therefore, we need to meditate. Therefore, we need to practice Dharma. That. So that's the conclusion. therefore, go to the beach on the waves. I'm not saying that, but therefore, they need to meditate. Praise Dharma. You see, purification, all the different purifications, the Dajikandra, the Bajasava, all the different purifications, all the means of offering mandala, all the different methods of collect merits, making the the water offering, light offering, all the various offerings, and chocolate essence to make prostration, so all the purification and all the various methods of collective merit to actualize path to enlightenment, to transform the mind in the path to enlightenment. So therefore, we need the statues. Therefore, we need the holy objects as statues to purify and collect the essence of marriage, so that we can transform our mind in the path to enlightenment, all like that. Okay, thank you so much. So, enjoy. Next time. So much.